We'll read a verse from Galatians chapter 3 and verse 14. This is really written to Christians, but it says this: Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. I'll just repeat that. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on a tree. You see, the Lord Jesus Christ took the place of the sinner when he was crucified on the cross of Calvary for you and for me. You see, Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. And the man who wrote that could say, of whom I am chief. That man who wrote that, under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, that message from God, as in the Bible, he was persecuting the church of God. He was persecuting the Christians. And he was getting them persecuted, and in fact, he was having them killed. And he thought that he was doing God's service. But in actual fact, he was being the enemy of God. And that's what you and I are by nature. We're the enemies of God. And yet God has sent forth his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, down from heaven into this earth, that he might die on the cross of Calvary for your sin and mine. He himself, of course, is without sin. He's absolutely perfect. And I want to present him to you again today. It is the only way we're ever going to be in God's heaven, through faith alone in the Lord Jesus Christ. I want to preach this message because it's the message of freedom and hope and salvation only found in Jesus Christ. You know, if you reject him, you'll go to hell when you die. And that is the absolute truth. You see, God wants us to know the truth. And for the disciples of Jesus Christ, God said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. What have you been made free? Are you a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ? Through faith alone in the Lord Jesus Christ. You need to become a Christian. In other words, you need to be saved, be born again into God's family through faith alone in the Lord Jesus Christ. The one who was made a curse for us on the cross of Calvary. He can be your Savior today. And that's why I'm here again. I'm concerned about your soul. Your soul and mine will go off into eternity. I wonder where will I be 5 seconds after I die? Will I be in hell, that place of suffering and burning and torment? There's no need for that. You can trust Christ today. Your sins can be forgiven through faith alone in him. Come to the one who died. He shed his precious blood. He was buried, but praise God, the third day he rose again according to the Scripture. So there's forgiveness available for you only in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. He that hath the Son hath life. He that hath not the Son of God hath not life. Are you still under the condemnation of Almighty God because of your sin? Or have you received the forgiveness which can only come through faith alone in the Lord Jesus Christ? For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.